Game of the year. Deathloop? No. Takes two? Probably not. Psychonauts, Metroid, Ratchet and Clank. What the fuck? Wait. Wait, is this really all the games we got this year? There's no shot. Guys, what else did we get this year? I mean, Resident Evil takes the cake here 100%. I'll be honest though, I think it takes two had a good concept and had a big variety of cool mechanics and interesting gameplay perspective. I think they really pushed cool boundaries when it comes to co-op play. I would give it a multiplayer game of the year. I have to give it to Resident Evil. Resident Evil was overall, I think, a better game. Chat. Resident Evil was a good game. It was a great game. I think it was well made and it looked pretty good. I have to give it to Resident Evil. What? Fuck no.
You never finished It Takes Two. Omega lol, nice take, Batchist.
Boom. Okay, what else? Wait, how do I go next? Next category. Best game direction. Oh, you know what? I'll actually get this with It Takes Two this time. Wait. For game direction, I think It Takes Two was great. I think it was super well done. I think the narrative and the story and the way it was done, it was super well executed. And for what they wanted to achieve, I think they did pretty good with it. I'm definitely voting for It Takes Two. There you go. And best Psychonauts, I don't think it matters though. Best narrative. Oh, no shot. No shot is actually this. Absolutely not. Guys, it was a bit of a disaster. Chat, what was the narrative like for Psychonauts? Chat, I still think either Deathloop or Takes Two. Was that the narrative pretty good or not? It takes again. I mean, it was a great game. I'll just say it. Next. Best art direction. You know what? Chat, guys, I won't be repetitive, but I'm actually impressed they did not put It Takes Two in here. I'm actually impressed. The art was real in that game. Not this. That was decent. Eh. British Spirits, maybe? Yeah, British Spirits was pretty cool. Pretty cool looking. I watched a couple streams. Yeah, what else? Yeah, Kenny wasn't that bad for art. Whatever. Best score and music. I have no idea, actually. Cyberpunk was pretty good, though. Was Nier good? Nier is always crazy for soundtrack. Let me see. Nier Replicant soundtrack. Yeah, it's the same style as the other Nier. Yeah, in my chat, this goes for either Cyberpunk or Nier, or one or the other. I think Nier's music has always been top tier. I think nobody can say anything against that. Nier's music is always fucking dank, especially during bosses and stuff like that. Or cutscenes, really, really good. They're really creative with how they do it too. It's not just generic. Okay, let it drop. Well, yeah, it's like the other Nier then. Yeah, they did a pretty good job. Okay, next. Fuck, man, I'm done. I'm closing the videos. I'm closing them. It's not my fault, okay? It's not my fault. Best audio design. That is tough. Wait, this is actually really tough. Forza, you think? I had no problem with Forza's audio. I'm inclined to agree, actually. I had no problem with Forza's audio at all. I think it was pretty good. Yeah. Village was good too. But I think Forza has more, guys, the thing is that I don't want to sound like I know more than I actually do. But whenever I look at sound design, maybe I'm wrong about this, okay? Some game genres offer more options or offer a bigger scale for them to show how good the audio can be, right? Games that have a lot of audio inputs and a lot of like small details, like Forza, you can really feel it. The rocks under the wheels hitting the car, the dirt hitting the fucking like the anti-mud, whatever the fuck, the wheels turning, I think they did a pretty good job at you not noticing it, one and the other. It was all working really in a harmony in Forza. I have only Forza. Best performance. Guys. You think him? Was it good though? Guys, it's kind of broken though. Guys, he's smurfing. He's smirking on the industry. Guys, he goes from real acting, Gus Fring, big character, big roles, juicer, fucking Oscar winner, worldwide, crazy nut zone. Then he comes in some game and just fucking claps everybody, man. He's actually smurfing, man. Games for impact. Oh, before your eyes are 100%. Holy shit, this is not even close. It's not even close. Guys, the effect that Life is Strange was trying to emulate for hours before your eyes could do it in minutes. I have to give it to before your eyes. That's just kind of how it is. Best ongoing. Apex is doing great. Chat, fans of Genshin, has the game been thoroughly enjoyable as the day go, whatever, and as the expansions come out? Has it been fulfilling as a player? It fell off. Guys, I was gonna go Final Fantasy, right? But at the time, I feel like voting Apex. Guys, they do a pretty good job. I'm gonna be honest, they do a pretty good job. They do a really good job. People hate Apex. Hate on Apex. The thing is that the updates have been pretty good. That's how it is. They've been doing pretty good at keeping the game alive with good updates. I don't know what this song is. Best indie. 12 Myths was amazing. Kenya was pretty good. Wow, these are all good. Chat, these are all really good. Apparently, Inscription was really good too. I'll go with 12 Minutes because I played it and I really enjoyed it. Lubio was fantastic as well. I saw clips of it too. Not again, I would play on stream a lot, but yeah, chat. Guys, this is tough because for an indie game, Kenyo did really good. Lubio was very creative and people really enjoyed it. 12 Minutes was very fun to play on stream. But Inscription looked very in-depth and the style of game and art did really good together. So it's tough, but I'm still voting for 12 Minutes. Okay, next song. Then Crystal Castle City. Best mobile game. Where's Bloons? Bloons, hello? Chat. Probably League. Probably League. Just because it's difficult to integrate the game that they had on mobile, I feel like. And because of how complex it is, I think they did a pretty good job with it. They did a pretty good job with it, no? No? Genshin? Unite was good, but too short-lived. Marvel, no. It's either Genshin or League. What do you guys think? Probably Genshin then. Nah, I guess I'm over Wild Rift, fuck it. I did it. I've over Wild Rift. Best community support. Destiny always does well with the community stuff. Final Fantasy? Why? Yep. Okay, I'll give it to Final Fantasy just because. I mean, I don't really have an opinion on this because I'm not involved enough with one game or two games or three games to know how much of an impact how much support they've been giving to the community. Final Fantasy is the next. Innovation and accessibility. Well, that's really tough though. If you don't look for it, this is actually really tough. I know some games are pretty good. With accessibility. Guys, let me explain it. Accessibility is how well they do without you noticing too much, okay? As somebody who isn't like impaired, right? How well they put stuff like subtitles, how intuitive the game is, and it's showing you stuff, and also, isn't it? Yeah, exactly, for a wider audience. And if you are impaired, how much they've innovated in how to help the audio impaired or whatever. I don't know how to say it, okay? It's for everything. Photos pretty good though. Read the screen. I read it already. Bitch. Oh, Montreal's remix. That's a cool one. What was I thinking? Ratchet and Clank? Was Ratchet good for that? Wait, was Ratchet and Clank good for accessibility? Forza then. Best VR. Probably not Hitman. I don't really know, actually. RE4? Okay. I didn't play it, so. Best action game, not After Blood. Chivalry, maybe. Probably Chivalry 2, right? Probably Chivalry. Far Cry 6. For combat? Oh, no shot. Chat, for best game in action genre, focus on combat. Chivalry wins this for sure. Wait, no! Deadly wins this! Then Deadly wins here, I think, for combat. No? Okay, Chiv then. Best action adventure game. The best action adventure combining combat with traditional puzzle solving. Resident Evil. Yeah, for sure. 100%. Best role playing. Where's my guys? I don't see xQcow anywhere in here, boys. Guys, where's my channel? I'm the best role player out there. I don't get it. This is kind of fucked. So cringe. Shut the fuck up. Probably Cyberpunk, actually. Probably Cyberpunk. Wait, but this game designed which player characterization and progression? Huh? Oh no, not Cyberpunk then, no shot. Absolutely not. Chat, what's the best one then? For customizable, yeah, probably Monster Hunter Rise. I agree, actually. Best fighting. Demon Slayer, no. Guilty Gear is probably. Melty Blood, no. Nickelodeon, probably not. Chat, I think Guilty Gear. Guilty Gear wins this by a long shot. Chat, Guilty Gear wins by a long shot. Are you kidding? Best family. For the best game appropriate for family play, irrespective of genre platform. WarioWare, maybe. Super Mario 3D World, maybe. Chat, Mario Party. Yes, It Takes Two is great. I don't think it's the best family play game. Compared to Mario Party. It's kind of broken. Mario Party's kind of broken for that. I mean, the game was designed and has been excelling at that for years. Like, how do you beat that? Best simulation slash strategy. Best game focused on real-time turn-based simulation strategy gameplay irrespective of the platform. AOE 4 or Microsoft Sim. I'm gonna go with Age of Empires. Chat, I voted for Microsoft Sim last year. I'm not gonna vote them again. I'm sure they go with Age of Empires here. Game's pretty good. Guys, it is what it is. Best, guys, best sports racing. Guys, I had to give it to Forza, but the bar is very low. The bar is very low, I think, for racing slash sports this year. I had to say it, chat, but I feel like, don't get me wrong about this, I feel like sports games, they're gonna have to pull a fucking rabbit out of their hat to refresh their franchises in the next coming years for gaming. I feel like they need something to happen. Almost like when Battle Royales were introduced to shooting games. It reinvigorated the genre, whatever. They need something to happen because these games are getting stagnating like crazy. Sports and racing have been stagnating for years, dude. But I still have to vote for Forza, but it's still a low bar. It's a low bar. Best multiplier. For all the online multiplier, gameplay and design, it will co-op and massively multiple experiences. I'm thinking about New World here. But at the same time, they've kind of failed the massive multiplayer aspect though. Sometimes. At the beginning. Guys, it is part of the criteria. The queues and the loadings and shit. Line was pretty good though. Yeah, chat, guys, It Takes Two, I can't vote for it against these, but it's too tough. This is a no, 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 and no. So one of the... I'm still gonna vote New World. I still think, guys, I'll vote New World because I know they're gonna win. New World's gonna win, 100%. Because it's at bigger scales, and at bigger scales, things are harder to pull off. I get it. I'm voting New World. I did it. Get mad. Content Creator of the Year. Guys, I'm looking for it's just guys, where am I? I have to scroll down? Did I fall off? Guys, I think I've fallen off. Guys, I fell off plus ratio. That sucks, man. I don't know who to vote for here. Guys, I don't even know who to vote for. Ibai had pretty cool events, though. Guys, I think Ibai had the fighting event, the balloon event. He had some pretty cool events. I think the bar was pretty low this year, too. I think I'm gonna vote Ibai. The Maasai event, yeah. Dream made insane content with the cheating. Jesus Christ, dude. Jesus Christ. Okay. I buy it because all the cool events. I don't think it's a bad choice. I mean, guys, he's almost guaranteed himself a spot in this like every year. So I mean, it's good. It's good. Guys, not including myself, I feel like this year though there's a lot of them. Because I feel like there's a lot of people this year though. I think only five, I think, is a little bit disingenuous. Having only five creators, especially with how precise in what they do some of these are, I would want to see more people in there. Best debut game, indie. For the best debut. Debut. That's not how you say that. Debut. For the best debut game created by new independent studio. Valheim. Kenya or Valheim? Valheim did really good for... They did really good. It's French. It's debut. Not debut. Debut. It's the debutation. That motherfucker. Chill out, man. Most anticipated game. Oh, Elden Ring for sure. Oh, Riding the Rock though. Oh, this is tough, damn. Wait, chat, these are all pretty crazy. These are all fucking nuts though. I think I'll give it to Elden Ring. I'll give it to Elden Ring. But I'm gonna be honest with you, I wish we didn't have the teaser. I wish we didn't play the beta, and I wish nobody played the beta. I know we played the test, so it was more of a mystery than the other games are. The other games have an advantage because of how mysterious they are, and what they have to offer, and how different, and how crazy they're gonna be, whatever. It's unfair to have a game that released a part of it already. It's kind of fucked. That's all. I don't think that's a bad thing either. I'll still vote Elden Ring though. If I were to take myself back, because even now it's still good because I played the beta. But if I were to take myself back, right, on how, oh my god, I can't wait to see what it looks like, Elden Ring wins. But God of War is nuts though. Best esports game. The game that delivered the best overall esports experience for players, including tournaments, community support, and economy updates, especially the game platform. Not Valorant. Valorant did chat. Yes, Valorant did pretty good. The problem with Valorant though is that this year they weren't loud. They weren't like out there. They did what they needed to do, I feel like, and they did good at what they wanted to achieve. But they didn't like break out of the sphere and go crazy. They weren't loud as fuck like everybody is. Like, you know what I'm saying? Is that a bad take? Like they weren't fucking out there. Like balling out, and I think this one again is like it was a bit underwhelming. League was good. Chat, I don't know. League was really good this year. They did pretty fucking good. Yeah, they've been going all out. It's either CS or League. CS did pretty good though. Guys, League did really good this year. Don't get mad at the game. I have to go with League. I guess I want to vote CS, okay? But I want to vote who's going to win. League is going to win this year, 100%. They win 100%. Best esports athletes. Oh, Tens for sure. Dude, Tens for sure. Guys, Simple is fantastic. But I just think Tens has been more like out there as like a well-rounded individual in the sphere. Compared to Simple. Simple is more like how would you say this? I feel like it's more like feel like a polygon of what they did or whatever, right? Like, you know, Tens is like you know, like out there like that. But Simple is like this, like, you know, like he's more like you know. That's kind of how I feel about it. Okay, don't get mad at me though. Not a one trick, just, dude. Performance and conduct, guys. I have all Tens. It is what it is. I'm sorry, man. In my opinion, don't get me wrong, but it's by a long shot. Tens literally lost all of his tournaments, and Simple won the major. But one day you'll realize that esports and whatnot, it's not only about results. It's not only about placements. It's just not. Well, it is, most of it. But it's not a loser take it. It's not a loser take it. Oh, this chat is still very esports blue pill. I'm gonna keep this stacking. What? Best esports team. We're using a specific esports team, not for full organization. The most outstanding performance and conduct. Sentinels or Navi? Yeah, that's for sure. Team Spirit did pretty good though. They're not wrong. Yeah, chat. Yeah, listen. Yeah, they win here for sure. Yeah, I think they win this time. I'm not biased. I think they win here. Houston Outlaws? What the fuck did Outlaws do, man? Houston Outlaws? What the fuck did they do? Who the fuck?
Why is the OWL reject talking about conduct in esports? L plus ratio plus kicked out of fuel plus washed up plus fell off plus Winston name plus shift 3 plus just go 42.
I'll look at Koma. I'm biased towards you. This guy's cool. It's a cool guy. Blade? Guys, he's probably gonna win. I vote Kickoma. Best esports event. We had an event across multiple days. Best delivered, best appearance of the spent broadcast audience. Guys, League wins this. What am I gonna tell you, man? Guys, it's not even close. League wins this by a mile. TI was dog shit. Guys, League did really good though. I don't like League anymore these days that much, but League wins this. I'm sorry.
Do you like this song, Link?
Oh, let me see. That was fun though. It's okay. I'll play in a minute. Then watch TI. Austria of the Year, and we already did it. It was 23. It was Gvevk, iBuy, Goalless, Fuzzly, and Dream. I have very, very bad takes about this that nobody wants to listen to. So. That was fun though. I enjoyed doing that. That was a lot of fun. just, every time I have a take, okay, it's either kind of cynical or people feel like I'm salty or mauled. But some of the takes that I have, I've had them for years, and they don't change whether I'm nominated or not, whether I'm doing well or bad. My takes never change. Because they're fundamentally, they remain the same. Because they're rooted in yeah, whatever, man. I think they're rooted in what's real. And people, sometimes they get mad at me for saying it. They get mad. If I say it, I'm ostracized. If I say my takes, people will say, fuck this guy, a brand risk, Andy.
Yo, can I get a welcome to the
job? In my opinion, I want to tell you, these awards shouldn't happen. You shouldn't have... We shouldn't have this is tough. If you're gonna have a content creator of the year, it has to be it has to have a lot of people in it. You have to have way more than other categories, because they're not games. They're channels that do a lot of things that are different. People do a lot of different things, and people gain, let's say, popularity in one way, or result in another way, or innovation in another way, right? In my opinion, you want me to go crazy with this one? In my opinion, we should remove three or four of them, right? Literally. And we should have a German here. Who is Germa? Well, most of you don't even know who Germa is. He's a pretty decently big streamer. But in the great scheme of things, people don't even know who Germa is. Germa did great for innovation and creative with live content. And that's something that's very important. It's something that we rarely get to see, dude. I really get to do that because I'm lazy. But a lot of these people, they do crazy shit. And except for iBuy, want me to be honest? I don't know what the others did in that respect. I'm not firing shots. I'm not saying they're bad streamers, okay? But in my opinion, if you made an important or positive impact in the community, and important, that's showing the way to what you can do, how you evolving, going boom. What do you do? What do you do? It's what you do that matters, man. And I feel like sometimes some of these events.
Biaro, shut up, no one asked.
Whatever, man. Ludwig broke sub count and did subaton. This should be there. I do think Ludwig should be there, but not for that reason. Whatever you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic, brain scattering, neuron busting thing I've ever heard in my life. Okay, if I were to take your take, okay, and apply it with this, we should have the guy with the biggest viewer count, the guy with the biggest sub count, the guy with the biggest follower count, the guy with the biggest chat count, the guy with the biggest emote count, the guy with the biggest PO box opening count, the guy with the biggest YouTube crossover follower count. Like, oh my god, man, like, fuck, man. Analytics don't mean success. When will people understand this? Analytics don't mean shit. Okay, it's easy to gain analytics through certain methods and maintain analytics. Analytics can suck my balls. Analytics don't mean shit. Meg's number two. Chess, it's not about being number two. What are you on about? You said analytics. I'm molding. Okay, chat, guys, I'm ranting. Guys, last one, chat, and then I'm watching some bullshit videos, okay? Listen. Every year, I give you guys the same rant, and nobody listens, okay? Every year, I talk to you guys, and I tell you about this, and nobody listens. Every time, I try to tell you guys what it's about, and nobody wakes up with this shit, okay? It's a very simple concept. Don't mute me. Don't mute me. It's a simple, it's a simple concept. Okay. Analytics doing shit. You can manipulate analytics. You can play your cards right and do analytics. For all you care, somebody could have had their fucking stream paid for and embedded onto Wikipedia, okay? And it could add 175k viewers all year long by literally sleeping on stream with a black screen, okay? Somebody would have gotten analytics by literally having nothing but an embedded stream. Boosting the analytics. Literally. Does that mean they're a better creator? Does that mean they did better shit? No. No. And at that point, you have to realize the numbers can hint at stuff, but it's the content that matters. It's what people do. It's what people innovate. It's how they push the boundaries of what can be done with live content for the people to enjoy more. What have people done? What have people done for the people that are watching in the chat, for the people that watch live content, to preserve the essence of live content that can be, enjoyed and enhanced by more? What have they done to go that benefits everybody instead of pushing the limits? And a lot, for a lot of people, it's nothing. And that's okay, dude. But I think we should celebrate the ones that do. Right? It was it. Oh, you're mad because number two, Bitch, that's your sub count, okay? If you want to do the plan, analytics, I'm number one, motherfucker, okay? I hate analytics, but if you want to go there, motherfucker, then I'm number one. So what about it? Your argument's false, not on its fucking face, motherfucker. Jesus Christ, man. Jesus.
I don't know what the fuck he's saying, but I'm zooted out of my mind right now.